So earlier we were chatting about kind of what it means to be a good ally with the other panelists. Kylie, what would you like to see when it comes to being a good ally, what not to do? What would you like to see moving forward?
I would like to see people taking action as opposed to just saying that they're allies or that they condone, that they don't condone racism or violence, or that they simply stand in solidarity with the Black community or the trans community. That's really nice. Saying that you're supportive is one thing, but actually taking action, doing things that will have an impact on our communities is what's most important. What allies can do is educate themselves, take the burden off of us who are constantly educating communities who are historically always under marginalization and oppression. We have a lot to deal with. So, take the responsibility off our shoulders, educate yourselves, educate other allies, teach them and hold them accountable. And honestly, doing the uncomfortable work. It's uncomfortable, but doing things like having a tough conversation with maybe racist family members, or if you encounter or witness transphobia or racism, call it out or call it in and don't let it go and not say anything, because that is contributing to the violence.
I love what you said about tolerance, because and I love this thing as well. I want to be tolerated. I don't want to be tolerated. I want to be celebrated. And it's one thing to be okay there, but another thing to be having advocates there for you. So I love what you said about that. Sherry, I'd love to hear your thoughts on how to be a good ally and what maybe not to do anymore.
Sure. Well, right off the bat, so in 2015, I brought in a bill that became law in Ontario to ban conversion therapy. We were the only province, the only jurisdiction in North America at that time. Since then, Manitoba and Nova Scotia have followed suit. But there is a federal bill right now that we want to see passed into law, criminalizing conversion therapy. I was in Ottawa with many advocates, including, I'm going to shout, give them a shout out, Matt Ashcroft and other survivors who are demanding this. There's no reason it shouldn't be passed into law. It has all party support, just about. So that's the issue on the table right now. And the best thing we could do as allies during Pride is to make sure we're calling our MPs and demand that that bill become law. The other federal issue is the blood ban. There is still a ban on blood donated by gay men. That should not be the case, and has been the case for a long time now. It's been a demand of the queer community for a long time as well. There's no excuse. Let's get rid of that blood ban. So those are two huge issues. The other, more local, is really just again, education that rights are there. Use them. And certainly access to health care, especially for the trans community. It's their right under our Ontario Human Rights Code, but it's not the actuality. So I would say those are three concrete steps that allies can do. They're political. They involve calling your MPP or your MP or your MLA, whoever's, and let them know how you feel. Don't expect that somebody else will do it. And as a former politician, I can tell you those calls and those emails count. They add into action.
Get in there and do the work. I love that. Vong, I'd love to hear your thoughts on allyship.
Yeah, I think, I do think that external allyship is important, but I actually think we should also focus on internal allyship between the different letters in LGBTQ. And I think that would make like a really impactful change, because while the larger queer community shares many common experiences, we're also made up of many smaller communities. And unfortunately, those communities haven't always chosen to be supportive of each other. And so I'm trying to focus on how I can be a better ally to other members of the queer community. And like, what I'd like to see are, there are specifically members of the LGBTQ community in enormous powers, like in positions of enormous power. And I'll just call them out, like particularly rich gay white men, some of whom run large multinational corporations, some of whom are high-ranking members of government. And it's time to put your money and power and resource where your mouth is and use your power to help the rest of the community. Like, we really need you. And like, I feel like what really needs to stop is what I call fair weather allyship, because the same people recently who have been showing quote unquote support by posting memes and taking knees, like these are the same people who were extremely critical and vicious toward the Black Lives Matter Toronto movement when they peacefully protested the Pride Parade a few years ago. So what I want to ask them is, are you still an ally when it's inconvenient for you? Are you still an ally when it stops your parade for a few minutes and you have to think about the history of Pride as a police protest? And will you still be an ally when the quarantine is over and you have like other things to worry about?